friends. Welcome to America, the world is America, for which you stand, home of the brave, land of the free, for which you stand under God. All men are created equal, and so are ladies. I'm not kidding you. So all the United States of America, the pledge United States of America is actually the pledge to our God, right? That we have kind of messed up on our pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag. It's actually the flag of the world, okay? I'll explain that to you, that it's amazing, right? And I'm going to put in even the Neil Diamond at the end so you listen to it. It talks about you and me, brothers and sisters, children of God, that we are light and love coming here from a long ways away, from different places through the from the heavens and things like this. It's amazing. So, okay, so actually this guy, like a messenger from God, explained it to me about America. I thought that United States of America, so I'll go ahead and move into this. United States of America. Don't you get it? United States of. So that means America is bigger than just the United States, right? So United States. So otherwise it'd say America States or something, right? Or this the American states, right? So America is actually the entire world, believe it or not. That United States was just a piece that they carved out and cut out to be United States of America. So you got to put America as a world, and I'll explain to you this is why. So I'm actually going to go back even to Hebrew to see this. There's probably other ways of explaining this and everything like that. And I do these things off the fly, these videos. So I spend about 2 minutes actually looking at stuff. So I got to apologize if I don't, you know, if I'm talking fast or don't have my thoughts clear, because I have to do these very quickly when I'm actually moving on to the next thing. Because the next thing I want to work on are orbs. Oh my gosh, you got a bunch of cool stuff coming up on orbs. All right. So the United States of America, right? It's written in Hebrew, such and such. You can see it here. And you can see that written in Hebrew, okay? Now, what's interesting, the meaning is land, okay? And it's in Strong 776, right? You can, I'm not much into the Strong things like this or whatever, right? But they do have some stuff in there. Don't get carried with the Strong thing, I've discovered. You'll strongly find that you'll be deep into that stuff, that rabbit hole as well. All right, it means the land, okay? So what land is this? It's all the land of the world, by the way. All the land that God created, okay? So the word is a noun, okay, meaning a covenant. Covenant, oh, you're kidding me. So the land of covenant, right? So then it says, a prefix means the. So the word means of, and the word is, of course, the Hebrew translation of the English word America. When put together, this word literally reads, the covenant lands of America. Now there's of America again, right? But you gotta understand that the covenant lands of America, like we landed here. Get it? Land, landing. See, I'm gonna go diverge here for a second and go to segue to something else. We are actually the aliens here. You are. Because I came from the Orion Belt, and I believe this one's a Sagittarius. I've been through that before, through the Mandela Effect and other things. I know this. Because the galaxy, the Milky Way, we're on the edge, which Carl Sagan says we are on the way outskirts of the galaxy, and now we've been moved closer in towards the middle to the other way on the arm. Okay? We need a different arm, too. The Orion Belt is also a thing to the Sagittarius. So, you're an alien. You are the aliens that was described, the invasion of the aliens. I think we lost our minds. We are, right? We are the aliens, by the way, believe it or not. Because you're in this world, but not of it. The Lord even said this. So we are the aliens. Now also, so, okay, and when you listen to the song, it makes sense. So you get it, when I play the Neil Diamond song of Coming to America, that is actually America, the earth, the world, everything here, right? It's not just a little piece, United States of America. See, it's not just a United States of America. It's America, the entire world is God's land. All of it. Every country, every piece, every dirt, every piece of sand, that is your God's land, okay? So when we pledge allegiance, it should actually say, I pledge allegiance. Now, see, it's hard. We don't blaspheme to that, those words, because they are honorable and respectable to our ancestors. So, I pledge allegiance, America, to our God, for which it stands, the world. See, you'd have to remix it to maybe the new beginning. God says, we have a new pledge. I don't know. So, there's going to be a lot of changes. actually words. Now, I'm going to have to tell you about this. Now, I'm really off in the deep here, but I'm going to do a video on this. That we have to learn to change the definition and the meaning of words. Words in the future, my understanding, we will not use the word hate. If hate is used, it'll be translated into love or some other meaning. I told my mother about it, or sweetness. Because hate is taught. It's the meaning behind a word. And we want a spelling, a dictionary. So the words of hate, even murder will not be there. I don't do deep. You know, it'll be something like remember I told you in our thoughts when we see a spelling, when they put on shirts or things like this, we got to turn it to positive. So maybe some of these words will go away. That hate will no longer exist because it'll be like heaven on earth here. And we won't have negative words, negative thoughts, things like this. We'll just be in peace, right? So that's what we're trying to, that's what they're trying to accomplish, is my understanding. So thank you, the Father, Lord, Holy Spirit, and all the other ancestors and everyone that's working on this for us. Because giving us those truths. Because if you take away the words, see, when I read love, I mean to have the sensation of, you know, loving things. Like, you know, I love little baby ducks because they're so cute, right? And that song. So like Kate said, I hate little baby ducks. See, it's that it brings emotion immediately because those words, that definition, the Phoenicians, so we're going to have to redefine it. We're going to become deaf Phoenicians. We're going to be the definition. We're going to be deaf Phoenicians to the words of hate, evil, negativity, anything negative. We're going to come with always positivity. Need to do it today, though. I told you, you know, every thought in your head impacts this universe, this world. So do it immediately. You know, so people try to entangle me still and pull me back into hating, and I won't be a part of it because a war in flesh is also war in the spiritual world. You cannot define the difference. You understand? We do not come with spiritual war. We do not, in my understanding. At least I don't, until they tell me that I've got to defend in a certain way. And so I'm saying we do not engage. Even the Lord even said, love thy enemy, which he also said, that also means even the evil spiritual ones coming from the spiritual world, right? Native Americans knew this, by the way. Well, they knew that, like the skinwalkers, I'm going to bring it up. Do not give that attention because you get energy which allows them to create and manifest into skinwalkers. There's a story about a guy that was a Native American. He said when his grandfather driving by Skinwalker Ranch area, and he said there was a skinwalker that he said he saw a skinwalker, and he said, hey, grandpa, there's, he goes, don't you ever acknowledge that ever again. He goes, I don't want to hear about this. He goes, because they saw it the other night. They're driving by. He said, I saw a skinwalker. And he said, my grandfather just let me have it. He said, you just gave it energy and made it manifest and you focused on it. It's kind of like the double slit experiment. Things don't exist in this world unless we give it focus. And we're not going to make things exist that shouldn't be here, right? That's like tuning into radio. If you want to listen to a negative radio station or something horrifying, you'll tune in. See, we're above that frequency. We leave that to lower frequencies, not us. We do not tune in to making those things manifest in us. Because we're co-creators for our God. I hope that makes sense. We don't do these things. So, and I had a hard time with it because I have to deprogram my mind. They program me from the, you know, a baby doesn't come in here knowing about hate and evil and all these other things. They are taught it. It does not exist. They come with love, peace, and joy. Look at a baby's smile on its face. They're taught hate. They're taught racism. They're taught all these cultural bashings. You know, us versus them. We are taught these to separate us, divide us, and separate our spirituality to hate one another. See, it's programmed. So we got a deprogrammed brain. And that's tough. You're like a computer. You got to unwind your brain. And it's hard. I'm trying to see, how do you turn the word hate into something good or just remove it from your brain completely? If somebody mentions it, has no emotion to me now. Hate, it's gone. All these negative things, these thoughts, you got to get rid of those. Because that's what we have to do. We have to deprogram that we, you know, all that crud, that bullying on the playground, all that crud, we have got to unwind those thoughts and those words, the definitions behind it. Not to go on about this. So we're going to do this. Now you're like, oh my God, you got to win the segue. Because, you know, words have meaning. And now America, you could probably decide more with that, you know, phonics. But anyway, America is the entire world, okay? It is entire earth, which means heart, by the way, if you rearrange the letters, right? Earth, heart. So heart. So America is the heart of our God, the world, all these other things, right? Our creator. And also the heart that the Lord and everybody puts our heart into. That's why you put a heart into the matter. I put all my hearts into it, okay? And I am too, right? So anyway, or the heart of the matter. The matter is the earth, the heart of the matter. There's so many statements I never realized ancestors even knew that they removed. I mean, my grandmother used to say words, "Hey, Kirk, you're pointing a finger at somebody's three-pointing back at you." That's like a gun. I said, really? That's what she was saying. She said, "You're pointing a gun at somebody at their head and their soul." She just say, "Kirk, you ever point your finger up so there's 3-point back at you? So if picture pulled in 3 fingers back, it shapes a gun with a thumb up." I'm not kidding you. So there's so much that we could have learned from ancestors, removed from the school systems, and even, they have, unfortunately, they've passed on to the other side. And so we've lost these things. Even Native Americans lost this culture. And the guy's trying to bring it back was telling me about the skinwalker stuff. This Native American, he's like, "Man, even Hollywood does not understand what true heritage was about." They said they didn't have no idea. And they said that we were, and he explains some of these things. I'm still trying to learn what he knows. And he's, I think he's Navajo. And the Hopis know a lot, too. I mean, boy, they know a ton. I mean, very different cultures. God talked to and communicated through many of these people around the world, right? And so there's all the stuff. And their ancestors passed those things down. We lost that way. And we've gone the wrong way instead of the right way. And right, we've got trapped in this materialism. We're looking at a mall, concrete, and all these other things. We understand these did serve purposes. I'm talking to you on the cell phone, that technology, that the Amish lost their minds, but we couldn't spread the word of God. So you got to remember, it's a balance. It's gone out of whack. It's not that a cell phone is evil. It sells like a cell of prison, like it sells your body, right? But also that prison allows us to be free, to get this word out, right? So don't judge God and what he's doing, right? So back to this America. Now, I'm just a little bit long, but I really enjoy spreading these truths and think that aside, and also brothers and sisters that have messages and did this. All of us are working together. Working together, angels in flesh. We're learning through, just talked to from Brett. She's giving a lot of perspective. Different things are unfolding. And a lot of friends and stuff, and we're working together. We're uniting now. And that's the thing. They're really concerned, these misguided ones. See, I don't want to use negative words. Misguided ones are concerned that we are waking up around the world. They are nervous because their nerves are getting banged. They're nervous, right? Because we are a conduit. We are the, we are the circuit. You can put this in electrical words. Their elections are electrons, right? They're trying to get the people given electrons for their elections. See, it's all in there. Pull is like a positive, negative pull. And police, pull ice. Pull, ice, put you on ice, freeze you, calm you down a little bit, not so hot. Anyway, there's a lot in the Fox. That's why it's important we understand even America. Now, United States actually means United States of America, right? USA. And so that we've been through this, United States of America, right? So you got to think about that. We're the United States. We're the United Ruled. America United Ruled, right? Under God, right? So you know that. There's something about Jerusalem. The New Jerusalem is actually part of the United States, is my understanding, because you break it up. USA Lem. And I forget what it was. Jer was something like, I had to break up the word, but USA is right in the middle there, the New Jerusalem. Now, that's my understanding. I could be wrong, remember, because there is so much confusion. So if I'm wrong, that's okay. But my understanding, United States right in the middle. Jer, United States, America, Lem. See? Jer, USA, United States, America, Lem. So the New Jerusalem is probably somewhere in the United States of America, but I don't know, right? And that's saying it's okay if we don't know because we just do a mission, because you can get all these rabbit holes and phonics and all these other things, and people are decoding through Dematria and all these other things. That's fine if they want to do that, but you got to realize in the end what matters is that we're doing our mission, do our job, we love one another, and we do exactly what we need to do with some of these things to try to counteract the Mandela effect and also to bring positivity and bring hope to these people. Because you are the light of this world, right? And that's why we're here. That's why we're moved here. Okay, that's why I'm going to play the song at the end. I'm not even going to talk to it because you understand. When you hear Neil Diamond's song, there's a lot of truth in his songs. I was blown away that how much he communicates to us through other perceptions, through sound, okay? All right, okay, so let's move on here. So the America, the land of our God, right? Also like the states of mind. Gosh darn it. Well, it's okay. She'll be fine. And so she's texting. She's trying to get lost. She needs to get some rest. She's kind of over pushing. Anyway, there's definition D. Hebrew is like he, a brew, like a coffee or tea, right? Hebrew, by the way, like Hebrew brews words. Hebrew is a brew of words, right? A brew like coffee or whatever, this stuff like that. I don't understand that completely, but it's like the alphabet soup, okay? There's a lot in there, right? So that's it. So what else do I have to add to this? I don't know really. I guess you'll say, I'm not sure, us, all, America, I don't know, you can break that up into, I don't want to add something to it, but us. And the stuff I'm going to reveal about the me equals we, actually. You turn upside down, right? It's upside down, not backwards and forward. So, me is we. And I'll explain more about that in another video. That's what the Mandela Effect's about. And some people aren't listening, by the way. That's okay. I mean, I've been reaching out and talking, and they said that would happen during these times. If you go back in history, they said that we'd be talking as loud as we could, even from the mountains and screaming, that there'll be ones that just won't hear our words. And it's unfortunate because I said, we're starting to figure this out, like, turning every negative thought into positive, redefining words, taking the sting out of them, all these other things. And they are just not listening. And we knew this because it was written 2,000 years ago, they wouldn't listen to us. I'm not kidding you. Over 2,000 years, they said there'll be very few. It's like the days of Noah, and he's running around screaming, hey, God said this, you're going to get flooded, right? And we're out there, warning these people getting flooded, and they're not listening. It is the days of Noah, right? And I'm not perfect. I'm working on self because I've been misguiding people. I've been misled. So, take everything I said again. But if you think with common sense, like in pennies from heaven, right? I'm actually standing across from J.C. Penney, which actually means Jesus Christ, pennies from heaven. I'm not kidding you. This is real J.C. Penney. I'm not trying to advertise them. Jesus Christ, pennies from heaven, right? So, there's a lot of truths here that I'm looking around, right? Oh, I'm in Westminster. So we got to minister the West, folks. And friends, we're ministering the West. Somebody's got the East too. Right? Because this is actually the Western part of the country in Western civilization. It actually talks about being the East. So it's East and West, right? Sorry to go on about that. Think about that one for a minute. Western civilization is actually the East. Western civilization, how the West was won, right? So there's a lot of truth. So even in and some of these stories, these legends are real, right? Anyway, so, okay. Oh, even Hansel and Gretel. Oh my gosh, the three little pigs is about the wolf, and the final one builds his rock foundation. He's solid. Even like the scripture talked about building a solid foundation. You could huff and bluff, try to blow us down. The wolf, the evil one, and it ain't gonna do anything. You wolf. So the other ones didn't take their time. See, that's the problem, is these people live in straws. Not just they're living in straw houses with their heart and their soul. They get blown over, right? And they're scared. And they go running so fast to not defend. So they move from a straw house to the wooden house to the brick, right? So even the stories talk about things like even London Bridge is falling down. It's actually about the Queen. Not kidding you, that she is going to come down. No, I'm not saying I'm going to do it, because somebody said this video, he's threatening the Queen. I'm not. That's the other side. And then this London Bridge is falling down, my fair lady. That's all written right there. They don't even know where it came from. They said the song. That's like these Mandela effects. We don't know where the songs are being changed and where they come from. And one guy even said it. He goes, I wrote a song. I can't remember. Wrote some of these songs that he's famous for. I can't remember who it was. Some singer and writer, a major guy. I mean, it wasn't... one of me, I can't remember his name. You guys would all know him immediately. He said, boy, there's this thought skin. I started writing down a piece of paper. Kind of like he got, possessed. If people get possessed by the bad, they might get possessed by the good as well. Like, get taken over to get messages out. I know it sounds kind of freaky, but it's real. That, their thoughts. You know, some call it the Holy Spirit, some call it whatever, but they can actually influence somebody on the positive. And don't forget, your God also, and the Lord, and these guys, they can take somebody over to push something positive if they need to. And I've seen it right in front of my face. Somebody started talking about something, like, how would you know this? I mean, how this person is walking out of nowhere, and they're kind of in this dazed glare, like, you know, talking to me, like, whoa. So remember, these are real things. It's because they can mimic on the negative side, they'll mimic what is on the positive side. Every aspect, and not as good at it, but they can mirror those things, right? So anyway, so back to this. All right, so that's enough of this. I'm going to head on. So you can look that up a little bit more. That's my understanding. So let's focus on those things if you can. You know, try not to have negative thoughts and don't entangle in the drama. You know, we just, you know, we're here and I can explain, you know, and, you know, these things like that. So anyway, I'm going to play this song and I'll explain to you. You'll see the light. We come from, like I said, you're come from far away. I came from the Orion Belt to Sagittarius, so far away. And we're here for certain things of freedom. So I'm going to play the song, and it's awesome. So I'm going to bring that up right now. I'm just going to play this. And, well, it went sideways on us. Here we go, because I can't spin it with this phone this way, because otherwise I have to spin it, and all of a sudden it might mess up the recording or anything like this. Here we go. I'm going to move this down here. Neil Diamond. Here we go. Oh, I just, oh my gosh, I'm sorry. Okay, here we go. We have a star. Free, only one would be free. We huddle close, hang on to a dream. Let's get out of the matrix. On the boats and on the planes, they come into America, never looking back again. Seems so far away. The old earth, well, far away. We're traveling light today. You're the light of this world today. In the eye of the storm. All this world, the chaos, the madness, in the evil. Eye of the storm. Eye, the all-seeing eye. The eye in the sky. Home to a new and the shiny place. Make new home here. We'll say our grace. Yes. Freedom's light burning warm. Freedom's light burning warm. We're breathing new world, new reset. Heaven here.
Everywhere around the world, they come to America. Every time that flag's unfurled, they come to America. Got a dream. Take them there, they're coming to America. Got a dream they come to share, they're coming to America. They're coming to America, they're coming to America, they're coming to America, they're coming to America. Country tis of thee, today. Sweet land of liberty, today. of the icing.
Today.
Of the icing.
Today. 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 Today.
Isn't that awesome? God bless you and love y'all, my friends. Just awesome. Love y'all.